epic journey.
The question is not so much where we are as when we are.
A mysterious odyssey.
World gone insane. An upside down civilization.
A visionary achievement that changed the face of science fiction. Now, 20th Century Fox unlocks the vaults and takes you behind the scenes of one of the greatest science fiction sagas in motion picture history.
Take your stinking paws off me, you damn dirty ape!
Take an adventure beyond imagination and go behind the planet of the apes.
Now, fight like apes!
The only good human is a dead human!
It's an exclusive look at one of Hollywood's most imaginative and influential series.
Smile.
You did feel like you were in a zoo. People did begin to look and relate to you like you were an animal.
Film by film.
Zero, I want that baby.
Chapter by chapter. From features.
My name is Taylor.
Hit it! Silence the animal.
To television.
You kill me, you kill yourself.
And beyond.
I still get fan mail from all over the world.
It'll kill us all!
Here, revealing star secrets.
I think that was my first nude scene. One of the coffee girls walked behind me. She said, nice buns.
And inside stories.
We had to look into the mirror as we ate so that we would not destroy the appliances.
Complete with never-before-seen footage.
Which came first, the ape or the man?
Hosted by Roddy McDowell.
It's a mind blower.
The ultimate ape event.
The birth of the planet of the apes.
Behind the planet of the apes.
It's a man of apes!
From Fox Star Productions in association with American Movie Classics and 20th Century Fox Home Entertainment.
Soon after Conquest's release in 1972, producer Arthur Jacobs once again asked Paul Dane to develop and script the fifth Apes feature. Dane quickly submitted a treatment entitled Battle for the Planet of the Apes. It continued the story of Caesar as he fights against a group of human rebels who possess an atomic bomb. Ultimately, Caesar is killed by one of his own generals, and a group of ape politicians and military commanders hold final governance over the planet of the apes. But Dane's outline was rejected. Arthur thought it was too bleak and too violent for the more upbeat film that both he and the studio wanted to make. Dane reshaped the story and script. But two new writers were also hired to give a fresh perspective. They were John and Joyce Corrington, a husband and wife team who had found science fiction success with The Omega Man, a recent film that had starred Charlton Heston. Keeping the title Battle for the Planet of the Apes, the fifth Apes film went into production on January the 2nd, 1973, with a budget of $1.8 million. Like all the entries in the series, Battle for the Planet of the Apes contained plenty of rousing action sequences.
It was a very low budget, so we had to reduce everything. I had to come in closer, not use so many people, come in closer, and rely more on quick cuts. Then putting it all together, it gave a feel of a lot of numbers and a big battle.
Pull back! Pull back!
It's a pity that they downgraded the budget for each film instead of trying to go bigger and better. But that was a decision taken by the money people, and we had to live with it.
Now, the final chapter in the incredible ape saga.
There it is, or was.
This is the hell my forefathers used to speak about.
This background radiation alone will give us 300 rentgens an hour.
The battlefield, a dead city 12 years after the ultimate bomb has been dropped. The prize, the right to inherit what's left of the Earth. The contestants, ape against man. The most unbelievable showdown ever filmed. As the mutants, strange, transformed men who live underground like moles, battle the apes to decide who will be master and who will be slain.
They're getting away. Kill them.
I want to love him now.
But we who survive will create a new race.
In the aftermath of his victory, the surface of the world was ravaged by the vilest war in human history.
Climaxing the epic series which made motion picture history comes the last, the most spectacular of all the ape adventures.
Now, fight like apes!
Out of the Forbidden City, they roared, to settle once and for all who had the right to rule the planet, ape or man.
In the beginning,